So before you put in the work to improve your local rankings, you need to decide how you're going to track your progress. And local rank tracking can be extremely difficult, especially when it comes to the map, because the map is highly localized. What you see from one location could be completely different than what you see just a few miles away, and both of those could be very different than what you see from any kind of ranking tracker. So today in this video, we're gonna talk about what you should be tracking, which tools you can use, and I'm gonna give you a few tricks that are gonna make this much easier for you as you start changing things.
The first tools that we're going to use for tracking local rankings are Google's own tools that they make available for free. Now the first one is Search Console, and you may not think of Search Console as a way to track local rankings, but there is one trick that you can use to make Search Console very useful in tracking your performance in search. And that is to use a UTM code on your Google My Business site URL. So where you put your website address in Google My Business, you're going to use this UTM code. You're going to put a question mark, UTM underscore source equals GMB, and UTM underscore medium equals website. You can copy that exactly like I have it there. You could make your own UTM if you have some other specific way that you want to track it and you're familiar with UTM codes, but this is a great one for a basic UTM tracker. And the great thing is, in Search Console, whenever that URL shows up in search, whether it be on the map or in a knowledge graph panel or any other way, it will show up here in Search Console and show you clicks and impressions. So you can narrow it down to just that URL, and then you can flip back over to queries. And this can be really helpful to see, let's say you want to see a specific query like this one, you can have a good idea that it has had this number of impressions and this number of clicks, which is likely in the map pack, but could also be in the knowledge graph panel, probably not for this particular keyword. So the first tool here makes a lot of sense to get a general idea of how that particular URL is doing in search, which indicates how your map pack results and knowledge graph panels are doing or how often they're appearing. It's not precise, it's not going to show you exactly where those things happened, but it is a good way to get an overview. I use this pretty frequently. The second tool is the Insights inside of Google My Business. Now, this is one that I admittedly don't use as often as I probably should, or I don't look at it very often. It's a little confusing to me because they do throw organic search into this. Like here you can see listing on search and then listing on maps. And I'm not 100% sure how the numbers are calculated here and how they're different from Search Console. But what I do know is that this is an interesting way to come in here and see customer actions, people who have called you or clicked to visit your website, photo views, the number of photos that were your own photos versus the customer photos. So there's some really interesting data that you can get here within the tools that are provided right inside of Google My Business. So check this out. And each of these has a little question mark. You can click this and come in here to About Insights and find a little bit more information about what these numbers mean. So this is a great thing to get familiar with when you're tracking local rankings. Next up, I'm going to move into other paid tools that are not Google's tracking tools. And the first one that I like to use is SEMrush. SEMrush actually has a really robust tracking system, and they have all kinds of options that you can use for tracking local ranking. Now, I'm not 100% sure if I really like this visibility score that they have. It's a little confusing, but what I do like to do is put in specific keywords. Now, I'm not going to get into all the specific details of how you should set up a campaign or whether you should use general terms that are narrowed down to a specific search location or use more specific terms that are a more generic search location. You can do some balance of all of those things, and this tool gives you the flexibility to do that both for desktop and for mobile. I do believe you may have to have an upgraded account to track different types of devices in the same campaign, but I'm not 100% sure of all of the details there. But this is a paid tool, and Like I said, it has a lot of really cool features. It checks daily. You can add quite a few keywords, and it'll show you the URL that's ranking there. A lot of really cool tools here. This is one of my favorites to get an overview, especially because I'm already using SEMrush, and so I don't need to pay for a separate rank tracking tool. If it were only for rank tracking, I don't think I would be able to justify the cost of SEMrush, which starts around $100 per month. But because of all of the other features of SEMrush and the ability to do keyword research and competitive analysis and other things like that, then SEMrush becomes a no-brainer for me as an SEO, and it may make sense for some other businesses. All right, next up, this is probably my favorite specific local tool, Local Viking, and I've only started using it pretty recently, but it's very handy to be able to manage a Google My Business listing all in one place and do tracking. They also have the best GeoGrid search that I've found specifically for any kind of business that does not have an address listed. So I found that Local Falcon may have a little bit, I like their interface a little bit better for the map scan. And what this does essentially is it shows you that you could be searching from different places around the city, and it's going to show which position your listing showed up in from each of those different places. And it lets you set how far apart you want them and how far you want the radius to be. It's a really nifty tool, but this one from Local Falcon only works if you have an address displayed. Now, if you do have an address displayed, you may want to check this one out. You can buy credits. They're not extremely expensive. It costs around $2.50 to run a scan of the size that you see here on the screen. But you could make it smaller or larger, so the cost just is, it's a credit-based system. However, Local Viking also has this built in, and you can do this without having an address. So you can do a service-based scan. So if I go in here, note this right here, I'm in on my property, and I have this little place ID that shows up right here. That's gonna be important if you don't have an address. That's not where I wanted to go. I could do a live search. I can go in here and I can change this to place ID, paste that place ID in, and then I can set everything like I wanted. I'm not going to go through the entire process right now, but I could do that same sort of map that you see here over on Local Viking. Plus, it does somewhat traditional keyword tracking, as you can see here, and gives you some other insights about what people are doing on your listing. I really like this as a local tool. It seemed to be the most robust specific map tracking tool that I could find. And again, it has some other cool features if you wanted to manage your Google My Business listing all in one place. And then finally, I tested White Spark as a local tracking tool. And it's very similar to SEMrush. It doesn't have some of the extra features like the map scanning like you could find on Local Falcon or Local Viking, but it does have some interesting, unique features. I wasn't able to dig into them a whole lot, but I found after testing maybe 10 or so tools that it was still one that I wanted to mention because it seemed to be pretty robust and have a lot of different options for adding variables. Again, maybe you want to check a general term like wedding photographers, but you only want to search from Columbia, South Carolina. Or maybe you want to check mobile or desktop, or you want to track your competitors all at the same time. There were some really interesting things you could do here. So White Spark is another option for tracking local rankings. Now, these come in at a much more reasonable price. I can't remember the exact pricing off the top of my head, and it'll probably fluctuate throughout time. But you want to check on these, and they're probably going to be something around the $10 to $25 per month range. To be able to do this kind of tracking. So the final thing I want to talk about is, I guess, what terms you actually want to track. And I don't want you to get too caught up on this. You can see here, I didn't go to any extreme extent. Now you can come back into Search Console and you could pick these from the ones that are currently showing you somewhere on the maps. Columbia wedding photographers in Columbia SC, wedding photographers near me, photographers, Columbia SC. These are all variations that I may want to add here in whatever rank tracking tool that I'm using. But in this case, I only wanted a few because generally you can even see when you rank for one, you're going to rank for the others in a very similar position in many cases. I do like to try to throw some generic terms or near me terms in and do those searches from a specific location if that is a feature of the tool, just to see how that's going. Now, that doesn't mean that that's going to be exactly accurate or how everyone in every place in the city would track, but this is a good example of the kinds of things that I'm going to be tracking. I'm going to throw 4 to 6 keywords into a tool like this just to get a good idea of the overall health and if it's trending up or down in general. Whatever tools you use or whatever keywords you're tracking, one thing to really keep in mind is that you want to stay consistent. Even if it's checking on your phone in an incognito window, making sure that you're in the exact same location. Maybe it's your house, or maybe you search from downtown or another location in a neighborhood nearby. You want to make sure that you're consistent whenever you do these different checkings every month or every few weeks, so that you don't get confused about the fact that you checked from a different kind of device or a different location or a different kind of tool, and there's just these natural fluctuations based on how that ranking was determined. Because local rankings are so volatile but also specific to the location of the searcher, no tool is going to give an exact ranking. There is no exact ranking. It's going to be different for every person who searches, at least slightly. And so you want to just try to be consistent so that you have an idea over time if you're trending up, trending down, things are staying steady, or if there's any things that you need to watch out for or check into more closely. Hopefully these tools are helpful for you, and you can at least start off with using free tools like Search Console and the Insights within Google My Business, or checking in an incognito window from your phone or from your computer. But then if you want to have something that automatically checks and you can go and check a graph over time, hopefully one of these paid tools would be a good place for you to start. If you have any more questions, go ahead and ask in the comments below. I will be happy to answer to the best of my ability. All right, see you in the next video.